This is not the lockpicking lawyer, and today I got a little mock-up of ID door locking system here. As you would expect, the door is normally locked, and when I bring a specific RFID tag close to the access control unit, we can hear and see that the door unlocks successfully. This all sounds fine, but I was wondering how easy it is to electrically pick this lock, since such 125 kHz RFID tags are not that secure. Now, the real lockpicking lawyer did a similar video about this topic, in which he read out the RFID tag's authentication data between the reader and control units. But I, however, cannot do that, because the reader and control unit is combined in one, and I honestly feel like messing with the lock system itself is not the best way to do it. Instead, I was wondering whether I could read out and copy the RFID tag from a distance so that I can create a replica without the original RFID tag owner knowing. So in this video, I will try to do just that, so that I can hopefully tell you at the end whether you can trust such an RFID security system or whether you should look for alternatives. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by Morning Brew, which is a free daily newsletter delivered from Monday to Sunday. Now, before subscribing to Morning Brew, I normally spend my mornings browsing through my Twitter feed, which, let's face it, is not that informative. But after subscribing, I receive daily informative and actually fun to read news about tech, business and finance. Like, for example, that Elon Musk bought quite a bit of Twitter stocks. It is a perfect mix between wit and informative, and since you can easily read it on the go using your smartphone, I do it quite often. So go ahead and give it a try by clicking the link in the description to subscribe. And remember, it's 100% free. First off, before getting to the whole RFID tag copying stuff, we have to know a few things about RFID itself and my door locking system. So let's rewind time back to the moment when I saw this RFID access control system on eBay for less than $10. At which point I thought to myself, this can't be safe, right? To find that out, I obviously had to buy it. And after studying its surprisingly well-made manual, I found out that I also needed a power supply as well as a lock. After choosing suitable options on Amazon, I unpacked them and also studied their manuals in order to find a general consensus between them. So initially, I thought a wiring diagram like this would work, in which the access control unit and the lock would get powered by 12 volts. And at first sight, this setup did seem to work just fine after powering the system. Using the given programming operations from the manual did also work to add an RFID tag that unlocks the whole system. But as you can see, after trying just that, there seems to be a short circuit, which the power supply luckily survived by shutting off. You see, the problem was that the electric Morteis lock instructions say that you have to hook up the four wires of the lock like this. But in reality, you only have to connect the red wire and black wire like it's shown in this final wiring diagram. This way, you do not create a short circuit when unlocking, which means that the electrical system was basically done. Of course, I also had to come up with a small mock-up door to go along with this locking system, but I do not want to bore you with the details here because I'm not that great with woodworking. So instead, let's move on to the moment in which I bring the RFID tag close to the control panel. In case you do not know, RFID stands for radio frequency identification. And radio frequency is the right term here, because if we observe the electromagnetic field in front of the reader with the help of a coil, we can see a sinusoidal voltage on the oscilloscope with a frequency of around 125 kHz. Which is the frequency this specific RFID system uses. This field is of course created by the RFID reader itself, by letting a sinusoidal current flow through a coil, which we can actually see by having a closer look inside the control panel. Now the RFID tag obviously gets penetrated by this field, and what happens next can be best explained by looking at this clear one, which only consists of a coil and a small IC. So what happens is that a voltage gets induced into the coil by the electromagnetic fields, which now powers the IC. The IC's only job is now to short its own coil using a transistor according to the data, aka bits, saved in its memory, which by the way is basically the unlock key slash data for our locking system. So by doing that, the transmitter's coil voltage gets a bit altered, as you can see on the oscilloscope. When the amplitude is lower, it means that the TEC's coil is shorted, and when the amplitude is higher, it means the coil is not shorted. And thus, our reader can turn this mess into an easily recognizable data stream, which hopefully contains the correct code that lets the access control unit unlock the door. And with the theory out of the way, I started browsing through Amazon and eBay to find fitting circuits that could help with my lockpicking task. What I found were of course some Arduino RFID readers, which I already had laying around, and this rather interesting multi-frequency RFID reader and writer, which I of course had to buy for my lockpicking. Like the product name implies, it can easily read the data from the unlocking RFID tag, since it is not encrypted, and copy it to another tag, so that we get a perfect replica that also works with my door system. But of course, that is not the end of the story for me here, since the to-be-copy tag needs to be super close to the RFID reader, which in my opinion does not count as lockpicking, because this is more like stealing a key and then replicating it. No, what I want is to read the RFID tag from a distance, like at least 30 cm. And to do that, I initially thought that I have to increase the strength of the electromagnetic field of the reader. But after opening it up, I noticed that its circuitry was rather complex, and I honestly do not want to mess with it, because there's a possibility I might destroy it, and I do not want to lose my only way of writing to RFID tags. Instead, I rather switch to this RDM6300 RFID reader board that you can get for way cheaper from the internet. Since the boards can easily communicate with my Arduino, it is no problem reading out the RFID data and then typing it into the writer in order to create a copy. But the big advantage of this board is that after I reverse engineered its circuit to create this schematic, I realized that it does the coil power amplification as well as the data transformation all discretely with op amps and PNP bipolar junction transistors. This is great because this way I can more easily play around with the amplification circuits, which I did right after I determined that the unmodified reader can read the RFID tags up to a distance of around 4 to 5 cm. With that out of the way, I started my modification by desoldering a resistor in order to inject my own voltage to power the coil. And while increasing the voltage, did beef up the sinusoidal voltage through the coil, as well as the electromagnetic field that can get received, it did also surprisingly decrease the RFID tag reading distance. I think the problem is that the feedback from the tag does not get detected better with a higher voltage, aka electromagnetic fields, which in conclusion should mean that we should not strive for super awesome amplification, but instead another coil design to maximize the distance. And since I have 4 wireless power videos under my belt, which I definitely recommend you to check out, I had some idea what I was doing while creating 2 12 cm diameter coils with my patent pending world famous coil making machine. Now as a reference, I hooked up the old coil to my LCR meter to determine its resistance and inductance. And the first DIY coil I then tried out came with higher values in both categories, and performed, let's say, pretty horrible. And in case you're wondering why I'm adding new capacitors here, then let me tell you that this circuit is creating a resonance circuit for the coil here. And since the inductance of my new coils changes around, I also had to fine-tune the fitting capacitance for the 125 kHz frequency. But anyway, my second DIY coil actually came with similar values as the original coil, and it also performed quite a bit better with a reading distance of 7 cm. So for the next test, I reduce the number of turns of this coil in order to decrease its resistance and inductance, but increase its coil quality. This time, the reading distance went up to 8 cm, which I thought was almost ideal for a 12 cm coil in combination with such an off-the-shelf reader. Now, I of course also tried out other types and bigger coil designs, but here I have to say that the small reader circuit with its transistors and without proper MOSFET driver is not up to the task. So sadly, I didn't get to complete a practical prototype that can read over a bigger distance. But I certainly had a suitable theory in mind, which I might try out in a future video. But through the experiments, I'm now at least very sure that you can build such long-range RFID readers. And if you don't believe me, then let me tell you that there are already such readers available on Amazon that work over a distance of 30 cm. So in conclusion, everyone can theoretically pick this lock easily by getting a bit closer to the person who carries the tank. So I would highly recommend not investing in such a security system. RFID is not always this bad though, because it is a big field with also lots of encryption involved. So better have a look at that when ordering your next locking system. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, consider supporting me on Patreon. And as always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!